Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to set up a secondary language to your Predictable account. So first of all, I'm currently working on Predictable English. As you can see, the word prediction is in English. If I go here, the phrase bank is in English. And the settings are also translated in English. But if I want to quickly switch to Predictable French, I can set up a secondary language in my Predictable English account. So to do so, I just open Predictable settings and I'm going to open the multi-language section. I'm going to select a language, French. Then I'm going to select a voice. So I have the choice, either a French voice, so with a French accent, or with a Quebecois accent. I'm going to select French. And I'm going to select Audrey. If I wanted to, I can also select a voice with a different accent. But in this case, I'm going to select a French one. And now I'm going to select my keyboard. As Predictable Français exists and is one of the 10 languages that Predictable offers, I have different keyboard options. I have AZERTY, I have ABC, High Frequency, and 10 Key. So I'm going to select the AZERTY, which is the one that most French people use. And that's it, basically. Another thing that I can do as well, if I want to, is to replace my phrase bank with the French phrase bank, basically. So at the moment, as you can see, my phrase bank is in English, but if I wanted these phrases to be in French, then I can replace this whole English phrase bank by the French one. One thing to note is that if I bank anything in the English phrase bank, then the French phrase bank will override what is currently in my Predictable English phrase bank. So that's something to know. That's why you should set up your secondary language as soon as you get Predictable for the first time, so that you don't bank so many messages in one phrase bank if you want to re-override it. So I'm going to do that. Okay. And now my phrase bank is in French. So that's it. Another thing that I can do, now that my secondary language is set up, is I can add this multi-language feature as one of my feature keys. So if I open Theme and Appearance Settings and then Show Hide Feature Keys, then I can select multi-language as one of my feature keys. So if I go back to the main screen, here is my multi-language feature. So when I will select this button, it will switch to the French language. As you can see, the English word prediction got hidden, and the keyboard got changed to the AZERTY, which is the French one. Back to English, I had the QWERTY, French, AZERTY. And so when I switch, basically my voice switch, my keyboard switch, my phrase bank stays as it is, as I chose to use the French one as the default one, and the English word prediction got hidden. So that's basically it. Something you might need to know, if you want to set up your secondary language to a language that is currently not supported by Predictable, you can still do it, but obviously you have less keyboard options. But I'm going to show you what you can do. So I'm going to set up my secondary language now to Chinese, let's say. Oh, Chinese, and then I'm going to select my voice. We have different accents. I'm going to select the Chinese accent, and I'm going to select this voice. And as you can see, I only have the option to select the native keyboard. So you need, you first need to download the native keyboard that you need. So I'm going to exit Predictable to do so. To open the device settings, and I'm going to search for keyboard. And keyboards. So here I have the English British keyboard as well as the emoji keyboard, but I want to add the Chinese one. So I'm selecting my keyboard, which is now downloaded on my device. And now if I open Predictable again, and I switch to Chinese, I can now select my keyboard from here, and here I am. So that's it. And so you can switch back to the English version or go back to your secondary language.